ライディングデュエル。それはスピードの世界で進化したデュエル。そこに命を懸ける伝説の技を持つ者たちを人々は 5Ds と呼んだ。
Alright, so last I left off, I still had the very hard difficulty for the time attack and the battles for the old highway. However, something occurred to me, right? Well, first of all, I think I already made this change on camera, I'm not sure. I already had these two pieces, and I was thinking that since there's like a specific curve that I have a really hard time with, and all the, all of the obstacles, I guess you can say, on the field for the old highway are specifically like oil and trash, things that affect your wheels. I had bought these wheel shields, but what I want to do actually is I want to start doing the other courses before I do very hard, because what I realized is, and I should have realized this a lot sooner, like, the normal difficulty is the same for all of the courses in this game, you know? So, if I can do very hard on Old Highway, I could easily pass normal and hard on every other course. So, we're gonna move on to the pipeline next, and this is essentially, we're underground in the sewer system, and there's lots of gates and whatnot. I really didn't need this shield, I could have taken it off. The pipeline is a little tricky. The timing is definitely very different since it's a significantly longer course. Like, look at this thing. Two laps on the old highway is probably one lap here. So, it's gonna take us... It says that you have to beat it within 2 minutes 35. Thank God I left on the wheel shield, actually. I would have not survived that trap. Or that trash. But yeah. Some of the turns are incredibly sharp, as you can already see, so that's something to look out for. But then the other thing is, for me personally, right, maybe it's a different experience when you, damn it, maybe it's a different experience when you're on the DS, or maybe my eyes are just freaking horrible, but when I'm driving, I'm looking completely ahead. I'm not looking, like, directly in front of me. I'm trying to see what's ahead of me 100 feet up, 100 steps away, and at certain points, because of the shape of the tunnel, it's hard to tell until I get really close whether I'm going to be turning right or left. So that's definitely an obstacle. I was able to dodge the trash this time, which is nice. It doesn't matter because I have the shield, but it would be nice to preserve the shield as long as possible for the battles. And now we've entered our maximum speed. This is like speed tier 3, probably. I'm gonna keep going. Because I think I'll be able to... Oh, that's a new trap, by the way. If you hit the button, you activate a bomb. I don't know why that's here in the sewer system. This is a really fucked up city for, you know, the goddamn security people. Just be like, yeah, let's just throw in a couple of bombs and hope somebody steps on one of them. That was a narrow dodge. I'm actually super impressed with myself. Holy crap. I think I mentioned this already, but essentially to get an S, and I believe this changes somewhat in the other games of the series, to get an S, you gotta take the times that they give you for these time attacks and subtract 30 seconds. Ah, so close. So obviously we easily make an S here, but the time is gonna go down. I think a minute 30 is the time we need for very hard. And this is what I'm talking about, is like, right off the bat, you can see that I'm capable of doing normal and hard for these other courses. So I wanna knock these out. No, I don't wanna go that way. What, do I have my balancer? I already forgot. Yeah, okay, I do have balancer. I don't need wheel shield. I think what I might want is a different type of shield. I'll consider it. I don't know. This this course definitely has a lot more room, so wings could be helpful, but I'm pretty happy with my speed. Give me a second, let me turn up my own brightness. I'll be right back. Okay, so I turned up the brightness. You guys won't see a difference, obviously, but I think I'm gonna go ahead and try out the wings. I'm gonna see what else is available at the shop, because I don't know, I just want to play around, since in my mind, you know, the pipeline is probably the easiest course, which is ironic. It's not easy in the, or not as easy, I should say. I don't even need to be looking at these frames. I just am. Beta frame. That's a 4-star. That's pretty sick. I think this gamma is already a 4-star. I really like this. I kind of like the alpha model, but I don't know, maybe it's the stripes that are throwing me off. If I could change the color of the stripes, that would make me like it a lot more. I obviously don't need a new engine or CPU. I'm just really looking at accessories. I think I'm okay with shields. What would the frame shield do for me? Absorb shocks of the dual runner, protects it from obstacles. Okay. I might invest in that. I'll invest in like a level 3. Ah, damn. You have to buy it then and there. I keep forgetting. Alright, so I'll invest in that. Maybe we'll try it. Maybe we won't. I don't really think I need a powerful wing. I'm pretty good how it is. Armor for both sides of the dual runner increases endurance. So that's just for my my life. My HP bar. Which I think I'm doing pretty okay on. There will be a course where that comes into question. I definitely don't need the boosters. Wait, what's the difference with the high boosters? So these say increased speed temporarily. Fuel itself is modified so it can be used even more times. Okay. Increases speed temporarily, but greatly reduces the handling. Ooh. A larger fuel tank extends its usage, and then modified for extended usage. Yeah. Interesting trade-off. I've needed boosters before in this game. I'm not gonna lie to you. I've needed them quite bad. But, and that's not even with these frames. I'm talking about with the main character motorcycles. I've still needed boosters. However, I'm gonna do my best for this series to not use them whatsoever. We have the accelerator, obviously. What is the turbo chip? Improves the engine performance, a customized version of the... Wait, so... I don't know what it means by improves engine performance. I'll buy one, though, to try it out. To see how that works. Because I am curious. Let's see what the... Oh, no, I didn't mean to go here. I could fix it from here. But, yeah, I don't really need to do that. There's... Get that good old keyboard ASMR going. Alright, so. can't handle any weight. Alright, I'll try on the wings. Oh, wait, no. I'm gonna take the wings off so we can see what the hell this turbo chip does. Okay, so it increases your maximum speed. That could be cool. For this course, it might really, really suck. But that could definitely be cool. We'll try it on hard mode. So, okay, so for hard mode, 215 minus 30, you gotta complete it in a minute 45, which we're easily gonna do. Okay, so obviously acceleration is different from maximum speed. Since we don't have the accelerator chip, with the turbo chip, I'm driving a lot smoother. I can feel how... Oh, I clicked away from the emulator. Damn it. I gotta stop doing that. With the turbo chip, even on an emulator, on a computer, I can feel how much easier it is to turn. Like, this feels sexy. That's the only word I can describe for my ability to swerve left and right. But obviously, I can't spark until the 10-second mark, where with the accelerator chip, because it increases how fast I reach my maximum speed, I can start sparking at the 6-minute mark. What is better for what? It really depends. IMO, turbo chip is better for this course because of the rough turns that it has. I don't know how I managed to narrowly avoid that trash. Okay, this turbo chip is intense, man. Oh boy. When you speed up, you speed the fuck up in this course. Holy crap. I don't think we're gonna make it. Yeah, we're barely at the halfway point. Okay, I'm hitting myself way too much. So, things gotta change. I'm not using the balancer chip. So yeah, turn on the balancer chip. That'll really help me out. I'll try the wing, as I said. And we'll go from there. I'm not struggling with this whatsoever. Maybe I'll just knock out the battle. Maybe I'll knock out the normal battle. It'll be nice and easy. Oh shit, I'm leading in first place. I assume that for the higher levels of battle, I'm gonna be going up against the security guard. I don't know what other character I would really be racing down here. Maybe Yusei. Since a lot of you guys aren't familiar, and since I don't only want to be talking about my bike for the entire however long I'm going to be driving today, I'll fill you in on the story. So, very, very mild spoilers for the 5Ds anime. You guys can skip ahead. I'll probably put a time mark right about now to let you guys know. But, so the main character, his name is Yusei Fudo, and he lives in the city called New Domino City. Neo Domino, excuse me. I don't think it's called New Domino. But the thing is, there was an accident a long time ago where there was, not nuclear, but there was an incredibly powerful explosion caused by the generator that brings power to the entire city. And the explosion was held in, let's say, like the east side of the city. So that entire, or the engine was held there. So that entire part of the city blew the fuck up. And the explosion was so bad that it split the entire city into two pieces. So one of them, it's not an island, but it's a floating body of land the size of a small city, right? And that's where all the destruction and carnage is. Then RIP to everyone who lived on the part of the land that doesn't exist anymore. And then everyone else, the majority of the population, I think it's the majority, lives in the mainland city. So it's called City, and then the messed up part, the apocalyptic part. Like, literally apocalyptic. They don't have food or anything. They're struggling to survive. There's a shit ton of orphans. It's really messed up. All the main characters are orphans. And they used to, like, eat maybe once a week and shit. It's all bad. But that part is called Satellite. And that's where the main character's from. So, Yusei, he had a friend who really ripped him off, right? His friend stole his motorcycle and his best card, so that he took it to the city and became a famous duelist, right? He became the dueling champion, basically. And they don't care that he became champion, right? It's not Yusei's goal or anything. He literally wants to go kick his ass and get his card back. So he had to build another motorcycle from scratch because he's an engineer. I don't know how that works because they don't have schools, obviously. They're like the epitome of poverty. But he managed to build himself another bike. He was riding it around for a while, making slight tune-ups, and then one day he felt he was ready. And so he came here to the pipeline. And the pipeline is the sewer system, and it's the only way that City and Satellite are connected. So this is where all the garbage goes, because one of the reasons the city is so clean is because they take all their trash, and instead of creating a landfill like the majority of human society does, they literally dump their trash onto Satellite. So all the Yu-Gi-Oh cards that people own in Satellite are really bad decks, because they're supposed to be, oh man, this card is so sucky, I'ma throw it away. And then later, when kids are looking for fucking food in the dumpster yards, they're like, oh my god, I managed to find a Yu-Gi-Oh card. And then eventually they end up with enough cards to... Nah, just keep going. I really wanted to say, fuck this, I'm doing really bad. I should probably take off these wings then. Because I personally just do horrible wings. But they're not doing too bad. It's really not that bad. Maybe the other wings at the higher levels are smaller. But yeah, I'm definitely... This isn't my best performance. But so that's what this pipeline area is. Yusei uses this to sneak his way into the city. And that's all I'm going to say. Because... I mean... Not everybody's gonna get into the actual card game. I'm not here trying to get you into the card game. Story-wise, though, pretty fucking great show. As far as the plot goes, right now we're on the 7th iteration of the show. There's been 7 different generations for the TV show. And people say that 5Ds was... they argue that to be one of the best plot-wise of all time. I think I got an S there. Again, I really hate that it doesn't tell you for the battles. I also hate that they automatically kick you every time you, Yeah, okay. That was for sure an S. So, I don't know what I'm gonna aim for this time. If it's 145... Okay, so that guy is one of the top security officers for the entire city. But he specifically patrols, crime-related activity and... things of that nature, gang-related activity he gets involved with. So, for the majority of the time, he's actually patrolling Satellite. He's a stereotype of police officer. So he's an asshole. He can be pretty lazy. He's unnecessarily harsh. But at the same time, as you get to see more of him, yeah, he's a dick for the first, like, 1.5 seasons. But he's just a genuine, hardworking man. Doesn't really have a family. Not that we know for a fact he doesn't have one. It's just not really shown. His name is Trudge. Officer Trudge. T-R-U-D-G-E. And, no, yeah, he's just a stand-up guy with a no-nonsense attitude. Which is honestly, as much of a strict dick he is to the main characters, it's also because he has to be. Because in an environment like that, you have a lot, and I mean a lot, of horrible people. They're all victims of circumstance, of course. There's absolutely no denying that. And this is one of the many ways that when you look at an anime through a philosophical lens or just in an analytical lens, that's one of the many real-life parallels that anime can really draw. There's... a bunch of people who have been marginalized, they've been discriminated against based on class. There's a socioeconomic divide that determines how you're treated, how you're spoken to. People who come from the class section where, you know, you're marginalized and discriminated against also face harsh punishment. And I mean, like, harsh punishment. Like, they have a section on the prison, and the prison system, you know, further abuses these people in multiple ways. It's just all types of nasty. But then on the flip side of things, right, you have a person named Trudge who one day wants to be a police officer, has a strong sense of justice and self-righteousness, and wants to make the world a safer place. And then you get put in charge of an area where theft is incredibly common. And not just petty theft, either. Like, there are crime and... there are gang rings, excuse me. I don't know what's happening to my English. I'm, like, hyper-focusing right now. Because I'm upset with myself for crashing so much. But there's crime rings galore. And I mean, like, people steal cars by the masses and sell them on the black market. So then you gotta, like, track down who exactly is involved in the black market. But obviously no one's ever gonna want to talk. So you're really pulling teeth and you're trying to find... You have to resort to extreme methods in order to figure out, you know, who's involved with what and all the plea bargaining that you have to deal with, and then the people who are literally trying to take your life because you're doing your job. It's intense stuff. It's intense stuff to be in his positions, and the only way you can survive is to be a total hard ass. Not a badass, because he's not a badass whatsoever. He's a good duelist. That's why he's, you know, at the top of the rankings. There's only, like, maybe five people who rank above him. But, yeah, I mean, like, you have to be a no-nonsense, I don't take anybody's shit type of person. And you're gonna be looked at as a cold motherfucker, yeah. You're gonna be put into a shoebox and, you know, generalized and all this other stuff. You're gonna be horribly misunderstood person. But in exchange for being so horribly misunderstood as an individual, and for the harsh treatment you get, you're making things safer in the process. Because it's not like satellite residents are... Oh my god, I am so close to breaking my bike. Holy shit. It's not like satellite residents are bad people, right? And he doesn't believe they're bad people. But he knows that there's a lot of deceitful people also. Like, to give you an example, right? And that's another parallel that they... I did fucking horrible for this. That's another parallel that he draws, or that the show draws, to the... Oh, no, I didn't do that bad. I kept that under 145. That's cool. To make another parallel to real world, right? We live in a neighborhood where people will come up to you and give you some pity story and some sob story about how they're going through this, this, and that, just to lie to your fucking face and steal your money. So that's just the environment that we live in. It really, really sucks. But there really are a lot of people who are like that. Okay. I'm gonna do my best to not crash more than three times. Because I really shouldn't be crashing more than that. I know I have a bigger body now with the wings attached, but I should be good. It's a bunch of smooth turns right here. The obstacle is trying to lean me towards the inner wall, but I'm not going to let it fool me. I'm going to go ahead and get back on course so I can make these smoother turns. This one's a little sharper, but I just got to be easy with it. This one for sure is tougher, but I made it. Oh, almost. That's one. Okay, only two more crashes that I'll allow myself, and then I got to start over. Which really sucks because this is a very smooth and straighter path right here, so... It would have been nice to come at this section at top speed, but whatever. I'll live with my mistakes. Consequences are incredibly important. Consequences in a lot of different ways for a lot of different people. Ah, that's number two. I thought I made it clean. Ah! Consequences for a lot of different reasons and people is some of the only ways that you learn, really. Like... And sometimes your consequence has to be harsh. Because then you have to really drill it into your head through those negative emotions and say, wow, I don't ever in my life want to be in this situation again. Damn it. I mean, I said I allowed myself three, so I guess I did okay, but shit, I thought I was going to do better than that. Whatever. I still made a really good time. Like, if... Ideally, you know, you're gonna have a group of friends who'll tell you, hey, you shouldn't be engaging in this type of behavior. And that should be your time and your opportunity to wake up and say, yeah, I have been a piece of shit lately. And this and that. But I'm gonna actually get rid of these wings and make some changes. So... Goodbye wings, it's been cool, sort of. I'll pick up the turbo chip, and we're gonna try the I'm gonna try the time attack, because I don't know if I'm gonna make the old highway time attack or not. We'll see how I do. But yeah, so that warning should be your first wake-up sign. And unfortunately, but realistically, a lot of people don't take that warning sign. And so they keep engaging in whatever horrible behavior they're engaging themselves in. And unfortunately, if you want to be a good friend to that person or a good person to that person, you have to say, I'm going to stop associating myself with you because what you're doing isn't right. And we've made you aware that it wasn't right. Even if you were somehow already not aware, but you continue to be this person. So I'm gonna have to let it go and end things here. I'm sorry. And that should be the ultimate wake-up call. Can you reconcile things afterwards? Absolutely. I never got to meet my grandfather. Either of my grandfathers, actually. They both died before I was born. But my grandfather on my father's side, so my paternal granddad, he had a saying that my dad told me recently, not that long ago, where he believed that you never burn a bridge too quick. And that was a real eye-opener to me, because after my dad had told me that, gave me those words of wisdom, I realized that, yeah, Was I right in letting these people go? Absolutely. But I could possibly still have these people in my lives today because there was definitely better ways of handling that. And there was always room to reconcile. There was always room to say, hey, this is now water under the bridge. I'm sorry that I was harsh. And then hopefully they're sorry that they did whatever the hell they did. And then that's it. You let it go. You never talk about it again. You're at peace with one another. And everybody's happy. Nice! I don't know how I managed to pick up that turbo pad. Sharp turn! Another sharp turn. Ah, I had to let go of the accelerator. I didn't want to, but I had to. I was going to crash so hard. Maybe, No, turbo chip isn't. I'm thinking of something that one of the other games has, where it gives you a speed boost, but if you get hit once, or if you stop accelerating, your speed slows down from the original. That was not good enough for S. Yeah, that was an A. Fuck! It's that one stupid turn with the oil patch that I'm still struggling with. God damn. Okay. I'll give this one more attempt. Or maybe I'll move on to the other... I don't know. I think I'll leave this here. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna knock this out here. In the next one, I'll do the two missions for these two levels. And then we'll have one finale where I do very hard for these four courses. So I'm gonna wrap it up here. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you next time. Later.